I guess I got cut off.
This is 20.7. Do 20.2 just for the heck of it. 2020.
Want to see what it looks like? Very fine line to get that right there. Well, like 21 hertz really wants to do it. But if I just barely adjust it, I can get it about right there. If I go any higher, it jumbles to this. Higher, kind of still the same thing. Let's turn up the frequencies. Weird how it changes. It's doing that by itself. It's alive. Funny, it's like in the close ranges of the 10s, because the camera's filming at 60, so anything close to like 20, 10, even if I drop this down to 10 hertz. Kinda wants to do something. It's really shaking a lot though. It's requiring a lot of amplification. So we will go back. see what this does if we leave it. Sometimes if you turn them down or leave certain things, they'll do different things after it gets crazy. This one wants to be crazy. 27 hertz. 8. Looks like that rotating pattern again. This is different lighting, so we're seeing it in a different way. So if I turn it down and then barely turn it up, watch the circle. So you see it's moving back and forth. Amplify it, the back and forth becomes a spin. And it's technically not spinning, just looks like it is. You gotta notice the bubbles on the outside, they're not moving. If this was spinning that crazy, those bubbles would spin along with the membrane. What's spinning in there are the colors and the surface inside the bubble material itself. It is actually moving really fast. If I put my light filters on, sometimes you can see it more clearly. It just depends on how the lighting is and stuff. Sometimes the colors will show and sometimes they won't. Usually I have to use a fluorescent light really close to the bubble, and that's how it kind of works. And you see the surface colors. But still, this is interesting to see how things have the illusion to spin around and twist. I hate when this thing does that. Sometimes my frequency generator will just jump frequencies. I really do notice something around 43 hertz. It's an interesting frequency. I see it a lot of times in even cymatics. Four hertz. Let's see if I change the lighting. See how much different the lighting looks? This is a LED light, but it's a microscope light with 144 LEDs, so it's kind of diffuses the light itself because there's so many lights. This one is 54 LEDs, and if I just turn on the color part of it, I mean turn on the white part, that's what the white part looks like. You can turn it up and the lines just kind of get thicker. You turn it down, kind of look, it's more dimensional. Add some color inside of it. particular light has yeah, so you can get it looking like that, kinda. Are like octaves, I mean fractals with octaves. See how it's just getting bigger the lower I go? That looks cool. 21 hertz. Back to 18 hertz. So everything is pulling apart. Amplifying it. Like I can continue to get this symbol to show up just as much as the cross. It's all about how much volume I'm trying to use within the certain frequencies, but it doesn't really matter what I choose. It's just a matter of how big it is how high I go, and how low I go, it gets... I go lower, it gets bigger, and when I go higher, it gets smaller. Different in-betweens, like stuff like this right here, where this won't form anything, it doesn't seem like, just wants to kind of remain, no matter how much I amplify it, turns into like this weird vortex. If I go down, turn it down, sometimes you can find the patterns inside those frequencies. Like this one wants to form something, so something close to this frequency is going to show us something.